If you saw the older video where I installed the project 1.2.1 for AI videos, yesterday the project was updated, and there are some new features you can look at now. In the Discover section, if I open the project, it gives an option to download. And when I continue with it, it looks like the existing project is being updated. Let me check if there are any changes in the text-to-video interface. Some files started to download. You better have extra 20 gigabytes of storage if updating. The project is running now. This part looks similar, 14 billion models, and the smaller 1.3 billion model. I tried to generate a video to check the performance. The prompt is the default. The model selected is 14 billion 8-bit model. The graphic memory consumption is still below 8 gigabytes, and 32 gigabytes of RAM is occupied entirely. After half an hour, I got the result, and it was good. This is a good progress for AI. Just look at the crab closely. He goes up exactly over the height of the tentacles. If you're watching for the first time, use this 1.3 billion model if you have 6 gigabytes of graphic memory. This 16-bit model did not work for me. The last is this 14 billion 8-bit model for an 8 gigabyte card with CUDA. The 8-bit text encoder works for all the models, and the 16-bit if you are using the 16-bit model. You can install Sage Attention separately, and I did that once but saw no difference. Maybe I did something wrong. However, it also decreases the quality. This works on Linux systems. I am on Windows, and you must be as well. Let me know if there are any Linux users. This boost occupies 1 gigabyte of memory to speed things up. You can turn it off if you're trying on a card smaller than 6 gigabyte. This profile option used to give errors works now. There are these multiple profiles, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Profile 1 says high RAM and high VRAM is required. It is for the users with 24 gigabyte cards. Second is for a 48 gigabyte RAM and 12 gigabyte card. The third profile says low RAM and high VRAM. It says 24 gigabyte VRAM but works on my 16 gigabyte card. You can check and find the best for your system. I will select this third profile and try using the smaller 1.3 billion model to see how much time it takes to generate the video. Click the Apply button, and after some time it says Applied. But above it says to restart the Gradio interface. So I did the restart. After restart, the smaller model was selected in the settings. But the profile got changed to default. I selected the profile 3 again and applied the changes. I tried generating the video, and there was no difference. I got the result after 6 minutes. In the advanced section, this T-cache now works, but the results are bad. This will skip some of the steps in the generation process. These steps. Below are the options to skip more steps at the cost of quality. This is about when the T-cache to be activated. If you keep it 75, it will start working after 75% of the video gets generated. This section did not work for me. Above it says about LoRa, let's try the image to video generation. I stopped the project and clicked this image to video option. But there was something wrong. The interface loaded was for text to video. From the above configurations, I selected this image to video option, then clicked apply changes. It says changes apply, but nothing happened. I tried something or the other, nothing was working. Then I clicked this refresh button on the top, and then I saw the image to video interface. The prompt here is about multiple mammoths, but the image is missing. In the video size, we have 480 and 720 pixel video. The advanced mode is similar to what we saw previously. In the configuration, we have two models for the two sizes of video we saw below. Both the models are available in 8-bit and 16-bit. The rest looks similar. The profile works the same way we saw previously. Select the profile based on your computer's specification. On the top, we have this LoRa, and this is a LoRa preset made by the developer working on this project. After I clicked, multiple LoRa presets started downloading. The download is completed, and we got a new drop-down here with multiple LoRa presets. I selected a preset named Squish, and I know this LoRa effect, just watch. I will upload an image of an actor, and then I will select the preset. Next, I will click Apply LoRa Preset. And below, I got a field with a title as a subject. Below, you can see the prompt with the word subject in the bracket. This will be the same subject as above. All the subjects here will be replaced by whatever I type above as a subject. This is a woman, so I will type woman here. The prompt will be like, in this video, a miniature woman is presented. Hope you got it. Next, I will click Generate. This one more should queue one more video in the pipeline. Graphic memory used is below 8 gigabytes. Let's check the result. After 37 minutes, I got the result. And the result looks good. The subject got squashed as clear as uploaded image. I looked for some mammoth on the internet, and then with the default settings, I clicked Generate. It took 37 minutes, and the result was good. I really liked the result. I wish it could have given me a longer video. Then I tried increasing the duration by increasing the frames. After an hour, I got the result, and sadly, it was a 7-second video instead of 8-second. I tried keeping 128 frames, but it takes 129 or 125 frames. And when I clicked the play button, I realized I wasted an hour. At least you won't be wasting now. I tried again, but it did not work. I will see what could be the problem here, and maybe update you on this. I tried using this Mona Lisa preset, and then this Samurai preset. It worked on 5-second videos, and the result looks fine. Let me know if anyone is using this. We're planning to use this now. I think I should try the comfy UI to generate videos. What are your thoughts?